What's going on, guys? It is that time of the week again where we get to see some previews of the next episode being episode 3. So, if you don't want to be spoiled, of course, click off this video. And of course, let's get right into it, shall we? Now, if you guys don't know, the Bleach website has been updated with a synopsis as well as a few screenshots that you'll be seeing on screen throughout the rest of this video. So let's get into the synopsis and what my general thoughts about this episode is going to be. Let's talk a little bit about animation as well. Ichigo and his group arrive in Hueco-mundo under the guidance of Kisuke Urahara and confront the enemy commander, Kōge Ōpi, and learn that he is an annihilator. At the same time, in the Soul Society, the captains of the 13 Court Guard Squad have reached the same answer after receiving a report on the investigation by the 12th Division. The Commander-in-Chief Yamamoto Genri Yusai, who had been told at the time of the previous attack that the war would begin in 5 days, ordered all captains to prepare for war and the enemy's return. Meanwhile, Yhwach, the leader of the Vandana Lake, smiles fiercely in the darkness. And that is all we seem to get. Now, after rereading the volumes, or the chapters, so to say, of going by the full chapter rule, it seems that this is going to be at the very start of the episode, given that this is kind of the same synopsis that we got from the last episode, was pretty much given the start of that episode as well. Now, going from these screenshots, you will notice a few of these from the PV trailer itself that we've gotten over the coming weeks before the anime's return, such as Yamamoto yelling, and this is basically him basically declaring war or preparing the captains for a war to come. This is following up with an Ichigo scene where he's grabbing one of Kōge's attacks, and it's really cool to note here that Ichigo is still holding Nell at this point, where in the manga he didn't, and then there were some panels of which he did. So it's good that they're actually keeping a consistency within the anime of him holding Nell throughout of all of this confrontation going on with him and Kōge. We follow up with a nice screenshot of Kōge Ōpi using his Volstandig, which is the Quincy Awakening equivalent of like a Bankai, I guess you could say, for those who are new to the channel. We get an interesting shot of Uryū reading a book, which, if you've watched the opening or if you've seen my opening breakdown, you would know that this is actually new original content and probably the episode of which we are going to see Uryū talk to his dad, Ryūken. And then last but not least, we get one of Chad and Orihime. And while this kind of looks like an action scene, it probably isn't. And this is probably at the time of when Orihime and Chad are probably getting damaged to some sort of extent from Kōge absorbing all the reishi. Now, what are my predictions for this episode? I do believe the majority of the episode is going to be Ichigo versus Kōge and learning a little bit about the start of that fight, with maybe Apache, Mila Rose and Sunsun also getting involved, with potentially Ayon getting involved towards the end of the episode, because I generally believe this episode is going to be ending with the Quincy invasion, where you get to see Bambietta, thank God, and also Harshwell, Basby, all those guys. I don't know whether they'll be attacking. I feel like that may be saved for episode 4, but I feel like it's definitely going to be left on the cliffhanger of Yhwach reaching into the Soul Society. So my overall thoughts on the episode pacing is going to be really interesting, and I think it's going to follow pretty much like episode 2 did with its pacing, because I think it's really cool that they're implementing the Uryū and Ryūken thing, so that's going to pad out things a lot more. So instead of doing like the first episode where it was 5 chapters, I feel like you're going to get a chapter each episode, which is going to be original content, or a chapter of which would be original content if you was to equate it. So I feel like if you are a manga reader, you're really going to be interested in the fact of Uryū and Ryūken's kind of interaction here, what Uryū's thinking, his, you know, his development as a character of why he does the things the way he does. Along with that, it's going to be a Sakuga fest, I fear it's going to be nothing but an action-packed episode, because going from these screenshots, it is very much alluding to that. You're going to get some suspense from the Soul Society, from the captain and commander realizing the situation that they're in. I feel like half of the episode, through the middle section of the episode more specifically, is going to be more garnered towards Ichigo versus Kōge and learning about the Quincy powers, and then towards the end you're going to get probably the Yhwach, you know, interaction where he's, you know, invading the Soul Society. So in regards to these screenshots, I love them. I think they look clean, the models look amazing. I really like Kōge's design. I think they did him really good justice. The particle effects, the textures of the Quincy, you know, energy eluding from him really hits a mark a lot. And again, the whole shift of the tone works as well, and I've got, again, nothing to complain about because it is keeping consistent. And I'm very excited to see what a full-fledged action-packed fight scene is going to be. And the reason is because, yeah, we've seen some little teases here and there through episode 1 and episode 2, but it very much seems to me we're going to get a lot of action scenes that are actually going to be longer than a minute for once, because, you know, we get a bit of a minute in episode 1 and then we get a bit of a minute in episode 2, so this is going to be, you know, quite a significant amount. Let's talk about the production, because there has been a rumor around, which granted probably came from me, but I do want to address something that, yes, quite a few months ago there was some production issues in regarding to this specific episode. I don't know what cut, I don't know what scenes, I don't know which part particularly had some bad production issues. But as a month ago, or maybe a few weeks ago, those issues have been resolved and things should be going on as normal. If we do see any issues of like maybe some off-model shots or maybe some incorrections here and there, they will probably be corrected in the Blu-ray release. So I've got no issues in regards to that. But you know, these things happen. No production is absolutely picture perfect. And again, I have no problems with this after all, because I feel like the reason why these production issues have happened to some degree, or why it was so important about this episode specifically and not episode 1 or episode 2, is because this is going to be, and this tells me in a sense that it's going to be a fighting episode. And with a lot of fighting, there's going to be a lot of cuts and a lot of hands on the project to get those cuts done and make sure it is fluid, it's in motion, it's very intense, action-packed and exciting. So I feel like, you know, with any of those episodes in general, you're going to have probably more staff, more freelancers, more hands involved, and you're going to have more, you know, room for potential issues as well following with that. But as far as I know, things have been fixed. That problem hasn't arisen for a few weeks now. So, you know, I wouldn't stress about it now. It was something that was maybe a month ago. So again, we can put that to bed, and I don't want, you know, anyone stressing about that as it is. But I'm very excited because we get to see a smidgen of this within one of the trailers. I think the main trailer where the Kitani opening was playing, it was trailer 2 or trailer 3, I believe. And again, if that's anything to go off by, it's going to look like an amazing episode. I have no problems with it. And I'm very excited and very interested to see how they're going to be directing this as well. And after all, I am interested in the direction of this episode, because while Taguchi has wrote it, he's not the one doing the storyboards for this one. So this is going to be a really interesting take to see what Yamaguchi can really flex with this episode. But yeah, I think each episode is just raising the stakes one by one. I hope that they do the severity with the Tres Bestia and, you know, Chad and Orihime. I love that they're getting more and more involved within this arc, and again with Uryu as well, seeing his side of things as well while everyone's in this situation, seeing what he's doing, because again, it's something we didn't really get in the manga. So it's good that we are focusing on the main cast still, and they haven't been neglected yet. And hopefully, I don't know what Chad can do in this situation, but then again, you know, the Tres Bestia couldn't really do anything in this situation either. So I'm very interested what changes are going to be made. And I'm very excited because the changes that have been made from episode 1 and 2 have been really fun and really interesting and a different take. And I've had no complaints about them so far. And any complaints that I really had anyway had been fixed in the next episode. So I'm very excited. So tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. What do you think of this episode? Are you excited for this one specifically? And is Ayon going to turn up? I think Ayon's going to turn up, and it's going to be extremely exciting. With that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this one, JaymesHanson. If you like this type of content, please hit the like and comment. The algorithm would absolutely love you for that. And with that being said, peace out.